Hi everybody, it's Sharon Spurlock at the St. Louis Arc, and I'm here once again to share a Charting the Life course idea and tool with you that I think is going to really help you have that great life that you're looking for. So I saw this great documentary this week, and it's really making me think a lot about relationships, and it was called Intelligent Lives. It's about three young people who are moving into the adult world and learning about the kind of job they want, building friendships, building what their future life is going to look like. And there was all kinds of great content in it, but there was one part in particular that I really was intrigued by, and it was a circle of support. And I'm familiar with circle of support. I hope you are too. But the idea is that we all build this group of people around us with both formal and informal relationships who help us make decisions as we move forward in our life and help us support us to have those decisions become a reality. So in this movie, there's a guy named Micah who has a circle of support, and you could see during the course of the movie how he called them in to help him think through challenges he was having socially at college in different ways. And I was just fascinated by it because, one, he was away at college. It wasn't where his hometown was, but it was also clearly this really engaged group of people. So I was really lucky. His mom and he were at this screening, so I asked them about building the circle of support. And mom shared that she had started with him in third grade, connecting with people that he came into contact with on a daily basis and building these relationships. And it started off super social, bringing all the kids together to have pizza and watch a movie or play soccer in the backyard. But as they spent time together, some of them built real relationships, real friendships, and real bonds with him and cared about what was going to happen in his future. And she didn't discount them just because they were little kids. She brought them in to helping to think about what the next steps were for Micah. They even attended his IEP. So he had goals. He decided he wanted to go to college, and he left Detroit and went all the way to New York. And I thought, how did he have this connection with all these people that were back in Detroit? How did they help him make decisions? And he and his mom said, nope. When he got to college, he said to her, I'm going to need to build a new circle of support. So he recognized the value in finding people that cared about him, that shared the same ideals, maybe shared the same values, and wanted to help problem solve together. So within the life course, there are some ways that you can use a tool to help you think about how could you build a circle of support. I like this tool because it breaks things down into two areas: people that care about you and people that care for you. So in the caring about phase, those are going to be the people that are around you for a long time, that are invested in your future and your success. They're probably going to be family members or friends that they know your history. They can tell all your stories from childhood. They're the ones that know your quirks and your preferences and are really helping you build the future that you want to have. And they tend to stay around. Then the caring for people might be people that are in that same situation where they're lifetime providers, but they're also people that just care about you in a certain part of your life, maybe during a certain transition or certain area. For example, I've got friends that help me when I'm going to make a big purchase for things that they're really excited about. Maybe I have a friend, Tim, who helps me with all my car purchases because he's really smart about that and he wants me to make a good decision. I have people that help me make good decisions about finances, about my health. And I have some friends that help me by helping me get signed up for exercise classes or other healthy things that are going to help me move forward with my goals. So I know I've got all these people that I can call on that'll help me come together when I need to make a big decision or even a small decision in my life. So this sheet allows you to identify those people. It also looks to who that person with a disability sees as somebody they care about and could be a part of their circle, because they may have a friend that you haven't even thought about that makes sense for them to pull into their circle. A bus driver that really helps them navigate their friendships from school. Maybe their personal trainer is somebody. I had a young man tell me his personal trainer was who he went to for money advice because he knew this guy was smart enough to have his own business in his 20s. That made sense, and I bet that guy's more than happy to help him with financial information. So who are those people, and add that group together, and then be intentional. Find a way to bring people together and maybe just make a small ask. Would you be willing to think about what the next steps are for this person? Hey, would you help them figure out what they need to do to be able to move forward to get a driver's license? If you make a small ask, you'll be surprised how many people might come into your circle and be there for a lifetime. And the payoff of this, even though this is really a hard thing to do, the payoff is that you're not going to be afraid down the road that your family member is going to be alone with no one caring about them and caring for them when you're gone. And I think that's a gift that I want all parents to be able to have, to know that their children are going to be loved and cared for when they're gone. So think about that, and I hope you'll try out this tool. If you want to learn more, go to lifecoursetools.com, or you can always call us at the St. Louis Arc.